The title is not clickbait. I really am insane, and I did also watch all of One Piece, which is 1,000 episodes as of recording this video, excluding fillers, of course, because I like to keep a bit of my dignity intact. I don't want to go fully into the weeb side just yet. I like to keep a bit of normalcy in my life for now, but this video is also going to be the follow-up video of the I started watching One Piece video. Is that enough videos in one sentence for you? But I made that video a few months ago when I was around episode 300. I was still a newborn getting into the One Piece world, and now I'm a veteran, baby. I'm caught up with the anime. And the first thing I want to say is, holy boobies, Batman. Post-time skip women. Jesus. Eiichiro Oda, you know how to draw the female figure. I'm really excited to see how big you go for the end of the story, women. But with horniness aside, I'm super stoked with this show, and I'm very excited to see how the newest arc wraps up, because so far, it's finger-licking good, and I probably will also get into spoiler territory in this video, but only for the anime, not the manga. Like I said before, I like to keep a bit of respect for myself. So where do I start? I guess I could do my favorite and least favorite arc and then do a bit of a pros and cons list so I don't end up making this video like an hour long, because I know that would be torture. It'd be like nails on a chalkboard hearing me talk for that long. My favorite arc in One Piece has got to go to the Sabaody Archipelago arc, because Bartholomew Kuma is such a sweet character, the true slapping king. He could slap your mom so hard that your whole lineage would feel it. This man is the only guy who could bring down that Vasily Komotsky fella. But the reason this gets the gold for me is because the Straw Hats take a massive loss. They get shared around like a dildo at a boy's sleepover. They just get utterly defeated, and I always love when the protagonists get their anal cavities ripped inside out like a Mortal Kombat finisher, because I just love to see the world burn, man. And it's also super emotional, almost even made me feel something. And it just really shows them that they have a lot of work to do before they can go into the new world and be big bad pirates together. And for my least favorite arc, I'm just gonna have to go with Dressrosa. This arc is the true embodiment of horrible pacing that the One Piece anime is known for. The arc has over 100 episodes, 118 to be exact, and this is where I took my break on the series for a little bit. I got absolutely bored at this point in the story because it felt like the end would never come, like I would never ever see the end of this arc. So I had to take a step back and breathe, you know, a breath of fresh air to actually realized that I needed to take a break for the sake of my sanity. And it did make me enjoy it a lot more watching it in short bursts to get through that part of the story. And the characters and the story of Dressrosa are very cool and super important to the overall story of One Piece. But man, for some reason, it was torture. Absolute horrible to watch that arc. Now for the pros and cons. I'll start with the cons because I have much less of those, and I've basically already said what I don't like about the show. The pacing of the anime absolutely sucks. I don't know if it also does in the manga too, but dear god, a full episode takes up about 5 minutes of in-world time while you sit there and watch it for about 23 minutes looking like a big dummy with your dunce cap on for wasting that much of your life. It feels like so much is going on, and then at the end of the episode, you realize Luffy's only thrown one punch, and then Zoro took a right instead of a left, and now he's completely popping up in a different anime. You know, where in the world did Zoro go? And that's really all the negative things I have to say about One Piece. I can say some things here and there, like a specific character or one specific scene, but that's not really a point that I could add to the cons list. That's just like a little miscellaneous thing that I could nitpick on, but it's just, it's a good show. It's simple as that. It's good. And now for the pros. The characters are superb. In my opinion, One Piece has overall the best characters out of any anime. Oda always gives you that thick, juicy backstory to gawk at, like Nami's assets. And the character design is also great. For example, Frankie Speedo that makes him look like David Hasselhoff, or the fact that every character in the show looks like they never hit leg day. But as far as the story goes, this is the most invested I've ever been in a fictional world, and it makes me feel really weird saying that out loud. I feel very odd and like oddly greasy after saying that, but the payoffs always make me forget about the horrible pacing that led up to it. It's just simply that good. I also really enjoy the power system. In my opinion, devil fruits are more interesting, but Haki is by no means bad. It's a top tier power system that'll just make you punch holes through your wall, chug a monster, and then kick your cat every time somebody gets a new flashy power up to show off. And that's all I'll say for the pros to keep this real short and average. There's just not much to hate. Did I mention the women, though? And now for the bonus segment here, I'm going to add in my favorite fight scene as well as my favorite character of the series so far. The best fight has got to be Senor Pink versus Frankie. So hard-boiled, man. You may think I'm joking when I say this, like if I was to say Panda Man was my favorite character, but this fight just hits so hard in the emotions. It's simply, at its core, a fight between two real men. And by the end of it, you have a whole new definition for the word respect, and that bib and dopper outfit goes real hard all of a sudden. And I also really did like the Luffy versus Katakuri fight. It's a very close second, but even with all its flashiness and seeing into the future that it had, Frankie versus Senor Pink's fight still had way more impact on me, despite not being the flashiest. And this cover art for chapter 1021, man, it gave me chills when I saw that. Goosebumps all around, even on my penis. Now for my favorite character of One Piece, that's a super easy choice, it's Whitebeard. The man died standing up and is known to be the strongest pirate to ever sail however many seas One Piece has. I was going to say the seven seas, but this isn't Earth. But even though he doesn't have a white beard, it's more of a white mustache, who's got the balls big enough to question him on that? Tell me, you find the guy who will question him on that, and I would like to be alone in a room with that guy for about 30 seconds. Also, this man just truly loved family. One might say he even loved family more than Dom Toretto himself. And yeah, that'll do it for this video of me recapping my thoughts on One Piece after watching 1,000 episodes of it in 2021. That's how much of a life I have. I look forward for what's to come for the series, and by the end of it, it'll probably cement itself as my favorite anime of all time. That is, if I'm still alive when it does end. But regardless of that, I'll see you next time. Peace out.